Hey YouTube, this is going to be my 1 month update with my dentures. Well, first things first, things are going great. I am still loving them. Some new adjustments do need to be, they do need to be made. But first things first, I want to talk about adhesive. Okay, I've tried secure a couple of more times, and I gotta say, for me, all the hype about secure did not work for me. Secure just, yeah, it holds, but I don't know. It's not very comfortable because every single time I try to, put secure on, it wasn't comfortable when I tried to go and eat and bite down on stuff. It's nothing compared to like when I'm using fixative gum care. Now, when I apply fixative gum care into my gums, and I go try to bite down on something, it's comfortable, it's cushiony, so it gives it that extra support. But when I use secure, it doesn't do that. So I don't know. For me, I really don't like secure. So I mean, I'm gonna still keep it around, but not that I'm gonna be using it much. The adhesive that I do love is the fixative gum care. Now that adhesive is great. As if you guys remember before, I was using the fixative complete. When I switched over to the fixative gum care, I actually like that better than the fixative complete. It's the gum care one. It's like it's just like an extra cushion for your dentures. It's like, so when you go down to go bite down on something, it's like a little cushion. And it's great. So that's the only adhesive that I've been using. I haven't been using any other adhesive. I mean, if you guys can see, I have, actually, let me go get them real quick. Okay, guys, so I'm back. So as you guys can see, which I'm gonna show you, I have like a few several boxes of the Secure, which it's disappointing, I don't know. But then the poly grip strips didn't work for me. So I tried them, didn't work. Didn't even hold when I try to eat, food at all whatsoever. Just I didn't like it. The fix it and complete, this stuff is great, but I mean I do like it. But not as much as I like the fixative gum care. So this stuff is great. I really love this stuff. Another secure. I mean, like I said, I have a few boxes of secure. I also have a few boxes of the fixative powder. Now, like I said, there is pros and cons to this fixative powder. What I do like about it though, compared to an adhesive like this, is okay, so when you wear this adhesive and you go to take it out at night, it leaves a whole bunch of like crap residue, adhesive residue on your gums. So every night you have to just kind of go and peel it off with your fingers and get all that crap off your gums, and it's not fun. It's a pain in the ass. But I noticed when I wore this that, the pros to this is, yes, it does leave a little residue in your gums, but then I found out when I switched with hot water and just took a toothbrush to my gums, it took the stuff right off, which that's the one thing I do like about this. Now, the only thing I didn't like about this is, yes, it held. But when I went to go eat something, it didn't hold very much. It felt like my dentures were trying to come off. So I like I said, there is pros and cons to this. So, but I really don't use this. So, and like I said, I have a few boxes. So, but I mean, I'm gonna keep it around just in case. I do have a little thing of the poly grip, the super poly grip adhesive cream. I haven't really tested it out. I'm gonna test it out, one of these days, but because I want to see if this is gonna be as good as my fixing it. So we'll see. I still got to test this one out. The other one that I do have is the C-Bonds. Like I said, now, like with these, I haven't really tested them out yet for me to even give you guys a review about those. But so, I mean, I got to wear those more. And the other thing that I do have is, I do have, let me show you guys. I do have the Ezos right here for the upper and then the Ezos for the lowers. Now, I was hoping that those would work, but every time I went to go put them in my dentures, I couldn't get my dentures back up. I don't know why, but for me, it didn't work. So, like I said, now I've got a whole bunch of the Ezos. So, but I'm not going to get rid of it because how do you not know that down the road, maybe it will work. So, we'll see. But otherwise than that, so yeah, so like I said, the only really one that I use right now is the Fixit and Plus. That is my go-to adhesive. It's the best for me. That's what works and that's what I'm sticking to. So I just, now I just have all these extra adhesives. But, you know, I'm, like I said, I'm not going to get rid of them because you never know down the road. I might use them. So we'll see. So, okay, so the other thing that I wanted to share with you guys that is a pro is that when I went on my hiking trip the other day, I was actually able to eat peanuts. Oh my God, I was so surprised. I actually didn't think about it because I you know, I just kept on eating them and just, and then I realized, oh my God, I'm eating peanuts. What a big major thing. I mean, that's when it comes to dentures. I mean, if you're able to eat peanuts, I mean, you're doing pretty good. And man, it's been a long time since I ate peanuts. Even when I had my natural teeth, I couldn't eat them because my teeth were so brittle and they were hurting. And if I did try to eat peanuts, my teeth would probably just break. So, I mean, it's been a long time since I ate peanuts. And I gotta say, I love peanuts. Almonds, pistachios, cashews. I mean, I like them all. So they were pretty good. So that was an awesome obstacle. So yeah, and you know, like in one of my other videos, like I said, you know, I was able to eat a McDonald's cheeseburger. That was the thing what, last week, something like that. That I'm like a McDonald's cheeseburger. I'm able to bite down on them now and bite. My bite force is better. I still have a little problem with chicken, but it's getting better. So yeah, so I mean, that's so far, as far as that, I mean, things are going great. Now the other thing is I do have an appointment tomorrow with my denturist because there's some things I want him to change. Before I go into that, but let me talk to you guys about the reline that I did. That's called Reline It. I noticed that reline for me only held for about a week. After a week, I noticed that my dentures were not as snug anymore. They were becoming really loose. So I had to end up doing another reline. So, I mean, so when you do the reline, it works great for me. Besides the point of, you know, it stings when you put it, you know, in your gums. But it's not really that nasty tasting compared to the, you know, reline that you'd have to go see the denturist to go put in your gums. I mean, it's not as bad as theirs, but otherwise than that, that reline did work for me. It worked great. It just didn't last as long. It only lasted about a week. And, you know, like I said, after that, it just, you know, I started to feel that my dentures were loose. So I ended up taking it out and ended up putting a new one, which I have right now. So, but like I said, this, you know, it's, they're loose again. So, also what I wanted to tell you guys is tomorrow I do have an appointment with my denturist. I'm going to go see him because there is some things I want to talk to him about. Like, I'm going to show you guys. So, okay. Sorry guys. Had a phone call. So, yeah, so like I was going to show you guys. Okay, so like, okay. So if I smile, I don't know if you guys see it. Okay. Well, you know, you guys not like I want to go smile really big, but If I smile, you see how that goes down? Like when I smile like this, you don't see gum over here, but you do over here. I feel like my teeth are a little bit like crooked and slanted on this side. See, look. Gum? No gum. So I feel like they're slanted a little bit. So I'm going to go talk to him about that. So sorry, guys. Just ended up gluing my teeth in. So yeah, I'm going to talk to him about that because I don't like that. And you know, the other thing that I wanted to show you guys is that I noticed is, okay, look at these teeth right here, okay? Now go and look at these ones. These ones seem higher and bigger than these ones down here. Do you guys see that? See, look at that. See how smaller this one is compared to this one right here? It's a lot bigger. It goes up more. It goes up to here, and then when you go back and look at this one, this one stops right there. So it seems like he should have put this one up. So I'm thinking maybe that's what the problem is, that these teeth are lower than these ones over here. Because look, so if you guys look at it from the front, see how much higher these ones are compared to these ones? So if these were a little higher, it would be fine. I don't know if he'd be able to fix that or not. It's a good thing to talk about. But yeah, I was looking in the mirror and I was like realizing that these teeth are smaller than these ones. And I think, which it's making it look like my teeth are lopsided, which they're not. It's just they're, I think it's the teeth on this side. Because if you guys really look at it, yeah, if these were the same size and the same, you know, they were up more, it'd look fine, I think so. So those are the problems I'm going to go talk to them about tomorrow. And also the fact that they're really loose without that reline it. So I don't know whether if he's going to do a soft reline tomorrow on his own or because he's my last. Okay, my last of my extractions were on December 9th, so almost December, January. Okay, so like I was saying, it's been since my last extractions were December 9th, so it's been almost 5 months that I've had my teeth extracted. So right now it's the morning of my appointment that I got to go see my denturist. I don't have my teeth in, obviously. The reline that I did have in, I ended up taking it out just because I don't know what he's going to do. And I didn't want to show up there with, you know, a reline. So, yeah, so I took it off. So, but see, as you guys can see, I'm going to show you guys. My teeth are really loose. See? It's like they feel big. It's like there's a tiny little space in there. Like, so if I put my tops in, you guys will see. They don't stay up. So they're really loose. Sorry guys. So they're really loose. And so I'm gonna I don't know. I'm hoping he does another. He's gonna have to do something because, I mean, obviously, he's not gonna leave me like that. That's for sure. But so yeah. Let me show you guys better what I was talking about. Okay, see those teeth right there? These ones that I was talking about. Now look at this side. See, they're way smaller compared to these. These are more straight. And see, it's like they're crooked. So yeah. So I'm just now, I got done getting ready and, I'm gonna leave the house here at 9:45. I gotta be up there by 10:30. And we'll see what he does. Cause I know at 6 months, he said he was gonna do a hard reline. So, and it hasn't been 6 months, so. And I'm not really sure what a hard reline is, so. Cause I know my gums have shrunk quite a bit. See? Some of my gums are still open. See? Yeah. So you can see the little hole indentations, but yeah, my gums don't hurt, nothing at all. You know? They're healing really good. So yeah, I like drinking coffee without my teeth. I do gotta admit that. And ice cream too. I like it. I will keep you guys posted and let you guys know what he says. Okay guys, so as you can see from the clip that I just showed you, I was sitting in the chair because, he ended up doing a soft reline. So I had to sit there and not talk or say anything for like 10 minutes. So the stuff is gross and it's nasty tasting. But, now my dentures are nice and snug. He made the adjustment. They're not crooked anymore. Yeah, they look great. So yeah, overall I'm well pleased. So now I'm just gonna go home, which is gonna be about an hour drive back home, but well worth it. I had to go get these dentures fixed, so. Yeah, so overall, I think today it went really good. So now, I like them better. So yeah, so you guys have a good day.